So we're here with Tamen Sursaw, the host and the founder and the CEO of Bottle
& Heels. It's bigger than my wedding!
It's bigger than your wedding. So can you tell us what people can expect to see on the blog?
Yeah, after I had my daughter, I felt like, I was isolated and didn't have a community of women around me. So this is sort of a forum and an online community to bring people together and women together and talk about all these topics that, we talk about in our circle of friends, but we never talk about with the world and other people out there. So that's kind of what it's about. It's about a balance of bottle and heels, motherhood and career.
Perfect. Phoenix, what are you looking forward to? Are you ready to party?
Yes.
You ready to party with Mama?
There she is. Oh. What would you like to say?
Would you say something? No, you good?
Should we see Capri?
I see him
going. Oh, yes, you're going to.
So yeah. What are you looking forward to most about people seeing from your blog?
I think it's just, for me, the authenticity of who I am as a person, I think is going to be really exciting. I've always been a truth teller, and I love to rally people and women and support them and try to uplift and empower people. So for me, that's the most important thing.
Perfect.
All right.
I think what's so great and why Tamen's, one of my best friends in the whole world and is because she says it like it is. And I think that every topic, whether it be about sex or motherhood or what your life is like after you have a child or even, the struggles of career. And I think that as long as it's addressed with an honest opinion and it's not kind of this is my dream life and not, glossing over it. Like so many websites kind of portray this fantasy of what it is to be a successful modern woman, and it a lot of makes people, rather than inspire them, it actually makes them feel that they don't measure up because it's so unrealistic. So I think that if we can address these issues and say, look, you know what, it's hard to have it all or not have it all, and to keep that sense of honesty and openness, I think we can actually end up inspiring women rather than alienating each other.
And I have to ask, did she color her dress?
She did not, but she is very talented and she will be a huge designer. I'm just kidding. Can you imagine?
Oh yeah, me too.
Do you know you can design shirts back there?
Yes,
you gonna design a shirt?
You wanna?
Yes.
You wanna? And do you wanna hold the microphone?
Do you wanna hold it for a sec?
And can you introduce yourself and look into that camera and say what's your name?
Capri.
Oh my.
And how old are you, Capri?
I'm 2.
And do you love your mommy?
Yes.
Oh thank God! Thank God we got that on
Nailed
camera. Could have gone either
Nailed
way.
It.
Could have gone either way.
All right. Today is a yes.
Let me tell you, we're from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania.
Yes.
So this is, we're out of our element, but we're here filming for Dance Moms, and we stay in a one-bedroom, one-bed apartment. So we eat, sleep, breathe, live together. And you know what? I wouldn't have it any other way. I do have 2 older daughters, so I've got a lot going on.
Oh, you're figuring it out.
Here with this one, at home with the others. But it's great fun. I get to know her so much better. I just love it. I love it. She probably doesn't. Too much together.
Tell us what you saw. Tell us what you saw back there.
The most thing that stood out was the Sprinkles cupcakes.
The Sprinkles cupcakes. And what kind of cupcake are you going for?
I literally just grabbed one.
Just like any cupcake. You've already had one?
2. Oh.
You are my hero.
I've been like a working professional for my, for years and years and years and years, and it's really hard adjusting when you have a baby because your baby wants 100% of your time, but you still have to work and you're still, out there and want to be creative and do everything. So it is hard juggling it.
So what's one piece you would give to expecting mothers? Piece of advice? I love the keyword out.
Yeah, my piece of advice would be. Don't stress out so much. Everything comes naturally.
You know, Bottle and Heels started as a seed of an idea about bringing women together instead of pitting them against each other. After my daughter was born, there was a period of my life that I felt quite isolated and quite lost. I didn't have a network of women around me. I didn't have a tribe of support. And it took me a year and a half to find that, to find women that all came together to empower each other and uplift each other. And I wanted to put that idea into something like an online community, an online network of people who can support and uplift each other instead of putting each other down.